Growing up, I wasn't shy. As a baby, I let anyone hold me and I was content. My nickname when I was little was Social Butterfly. I didn't know a stranger. I had always had good health aside from having asthma. As I grew older, soccer became my way to let everything out. It was my stress reliever. My only problem was broken bones from sports. That was until August of 2013, on a cruise ship. My life was flipped upside down and I wasn't prepared for the roller coaster that was coming. It started with hot flashes and stomach pain, to being on bed rest. None of the doctors believed me. My first kidney stone was found 6 months later and taken out in March of 2014. We thought the problem was solved and I could go back to being myself. Little did we know, it would continue. More symptoms appeared: the migraines, depression, anxiety, fainting, nausea, weight loss, no appetite. The list could go on and on. I was called crazy and turned away by many doctors. At this point, high school had started and I was depressed and hopeless. The only thing that kept me going was soccer, which had become really hard for me due to my health problems. But I pushed through it and played the game that I loved. Besides soccer, I had given up on myself. But luckily, my pediatrician hadn't given up on me. In February of 2015, I was referred to Cincinnati Children's Hospital. These doctors actually believed me. I had found hope again. I had found people who wanted to help me become myself and go back to living a normal life. Even though I had hope, I still hadn't found myself. I didn't know who I was. I was lost. I was living in my own world, wondering why I was being put through this. At this point, the only person who I felt hadn't given up on me was my pediatrician, Dr. Camber. In January of 2016, I started group therapy for teens with chronic pain. I was actually very against therapy at first because I thought it was cliche and it meant I was broken. But therapy changed my life for the better. I was in group therapy with two girls who were going through things like I was. I couldn't believe there were actually people out there who understood what I was going through. Through therapy, I learned how to cope with everything and that there's always a positive to a negative situation. 2016 was a rough year, along with 2017. Starting my junior year, it became incredibly hard for me to play soccer 3 days a week and practice 2 days a week with my health problems, so I gave up on playing. I was lost again. I missed too many days of school, I fought infections, I spent weeks in the hospital, and had multiple kidney stone surgeries. I was down to 90 pounds at Thanksgiving of 2016. Since then, we've been to Cincinnati Children's, Cleveland Clinic, and many other specialists who are all confused about what my body goes through. Essentially, no one knows what my illness is. My pediatrician has always told me that my body is ahead of technology and one day they will figure it out. At the middle of my junior year, I was finally able to pull myself out of depression mode and put myself back together again. I learned how to love myself. I learned how to be independent, and I learned how important it is to have friends and family by your side who support you unconditionally. In March of 2017, I was involved in a car accident that changed my perspective on life. I learned that through my wreck that life is short and doesn't last forever. I decided I was done being unhappy and depressed. I was going to find a way to love myself forever, whether I was 90 pounds or 115 pounds. I was going to appreciate life and my friends and everything around me. I was going to live life to the fullest. I accepted that I was chronically sick and there wasn't anything I could do but live with it. And that's exactly what I did. With the help of my therapist, pediatrician, and Google, I convinced my parents it was time I tried an emotional support dog. I'd never had doggies before, so I was a little eerie. I found a dog through the Humane Society website. I went behind my mom's back and went to meet him on my own. I was told that he was about to be moved to another shelter because he was cranky and bothered the other dogs. I convinced my parents to let me bring him home the next day. Justice and I have been best friends ever since. He has turned my life upside down and shown me what unconditional love is. He has motivated me to keep going even when I feel like I can't go any longer. He has taught me that life isn't all about me. I've put my all into him just like he has to me. He's the perfect example of an emotional support dog. He licks my tears and sits right by me when I'm sick or recovering. Although my bank account may be empty because of him, he knows me more than anyone else and has shown me that I'm more than what I thought I was in 2015. Since 2013, I've had dozens of surgeries and procedures. Over the last 5 years, I have realized that I may not be able to change what happens to me, but I can change what I make of it. I have learned to find the good in everything and to never give up. I am more than grateful for my friends who have helped me through this journey and my family who have stood by me. Although I had to grow up at a young age and I didn't really get to live out my teenage years due to being sick, I'm grateful that this happened to me. It has turned me into the person I am today and changed the way I see life. This year, I have surprised myself with how much I can do and how far I can go. I'm the happiest I've been in 5 years. I'm proud of myself for everything I've overcome, but my fight isn't over yet. As Randy Pausch said, it's not how hard you hit, it's how hard you get hit and keep moving forward.